Okay, like an ETA. Century, any other systems? Nah. Guess we're going to Century.
Message coming in, Commander. Big surprise, the Alliance needs you again.
Of course.
Shepard, this is Admiral Hackett with Alliance Command. We've got a mission for you.
Do you?
An Alliance officer named Major Kyle has set up a small compound in the Hulking Eta Cluster. He's attracted a number of followers, mostly biotics. He's become an outspoken critic of the Alliance, and we believe he's mentally unstable. This could be trouble, Shepard.
Maybe you're overreacting, but I know you're not. Let's go down this road anyway. See
what kind of proof
us.
Do you have that the Major is dangerous?
3 days ago, we sent 2 Alliance representatives to meet with him at his compound. They've disappeared. We believe Kyle and his followers killed them. That compound is a cult, Shepard. They call him Father Kyle now. He set himself up as some kind of religious leader.
Okay. Kyle's followers.
You said his followers were biotics?
L2s?
Yes. Major Kyle never showed any biotic tendencies himself, though. I think he's just latched onto a group he identifies with. Many biotics feel marginalized or ostracized by society. Kyle probably sees them as victims who need his protection, and they see him as someone who will fight for them. Unfortunately, he's convinced them that the Alliance is somehow responsible for all their problems. We can't let him go on like this.
Well, it's technically not the Alliance. It's probably Cerberus. Missing Alliance officers.
What were those Alliance representatives going to talk to Major Kyle about?
They wanted to bring him back to an Alliance facility for treatment. Major Kyle served us faithfully for many years. We weren't going to abandon him. Given his state of mind, however, he probably saw them as a threat. We're almost certain he had his followers killed him.
Okay, and what about Major Kyle?
What else can you tell me about Major Kyle?
He used to be a model soldier, but something happened to him at Torfin. Too many Alliance soldiers died under his command. Couldn't cope with the guilt. His psych evaluation showed he couldn't handle the stress of command anymore. He was given an honorable discharge in early retirement. We'd hoped he would get better in time, but we underestimated how far gone he was. Now it looks like it's too late.
It's never too late. Maybe I can reason with him.
I might be able to end this without violence.
You serve with him. He might listen to you. But he's already killed 2 Alliance representatives. I trust you to use your judgment. Hack it out.
That sucks. Having so many people die under your command. It's rough. Unless you're playing Halo Wars, in which case, it's probably not. Press Rup. Okay. No population, so that's probably where we're... Well, I'm pretty sure that's where we're going anyway. It's a gas giant? Oh wait, bugger. Forgot to scroll down. I didn't forget-y. And I know there is something in the asteroid field, but I'm just going to make sure it is the only object. Okay. It's a metallic asteroid. Heavy metal. Palladium. Good on us. We got anything here? Yes, we do. Light metal. Cobalt. Ferrobot. Medallion recovered while scanning the planned Ferropoto. I'm not sure. Okay. You discovered a tiny moon with some odd readings. Further scans by Chief Engineer Adams reveal a destroyed skip pod. Your salvage team recovered components and found a League of One medallion. Every time I read that, I just keep thinking of the League of Assassins. But let's go to Press Rop. Is it a fresh Armada? It's a wide open field. Well, if nothing else over here.
Yep.
It can spit behind itself. Ow. Son of a... Round two. Let's do this, bitch. Where you at? Nope. Not having that nonsense happen to me again. Okay, so far I know three of his spawn locations. One of them's right here. Son of a bitch. If I just stick around here, it can't kill me. Let's heal up. How do you like them apples, you son of a bitch? Oh, we got red on our radar. What's this? I'm gonna save so I don't have to drive back up the mountain. That mountain! Apparently they are going to destroy me. I mean, I've got the high ground down again. So what do we have down here then? A ship? Scavengers? Oh, wow. That landing. 10 out of 10. Or cultists. Probably the latter. Well, if they're L2s, it makes sense. They've probably gone a little bit cuckoo. But that's why we're here. Kill a bunch of people and bring the ones that aren't trying to kill us home.
Area secured.
Wrecked mining vehicle. That's not a mining vehicle, that's a Mako. The front of the rover is crumbled and from impact. A glance inside tells you the occupants probably. A team of illegal wildcat miners are dead. Debris is still sliding down the furrows left by its tires, silent in the near vacuum atmosphere. What happened here? Discovery is cluster of prefab utility shacks have a distinctly ramshackle look to them. A set of rover tracks lead away from the mountain ridge to the southwest.
Redeploying.
It's probably a better idea to see it inside.
This is a private sanctuary. Outsiders are not welcome here.
I have to see Major Kyle.
I need to talk to the man in charge. It's important.
Father Kyle wants nothing more to do with the Alliance.
I'm just here to help.
I want this to end peacefully. If he doesn't see me, people could get hurt.
We won't let you take Father Kyle away. He protects us. We need
so defensive. He needs my help, though.
The Alliance wants someone to pay for those murders. Let me speak to Major Kyle, and maybe I can find some way to help you all get out of this alive.
Wait. Father Kyle will speak with you. Head to the building at the far end of the compound. He'll meet you there.
I don't know. Where the hell is he? Unless he's in another building. On the other side of the compound. In which case, that makes a little bit more sense. Or we've encountered a glitch. Equally likely. Oh, no, over here. I'm a dum-dum. Ah, 10 minutes of exploring. And the answer is right outside. More cultists. Oh, I would have had to go in. Right, okay. So I would have had to go in there, fight for a bunch of people, and then open the silo. Or the underground complex.
Try to take Father Kyle away from us, you'll end up like those other Alliance soldiers.
Or you will end up like them. Dead and dying. Easy decryption. A little quick save. Never hurts anybody. Come on now. Don't be a scumbag. It was a scumbag. The one that bounces around. I got a grenade. Not too bad. Not too bad. Do a little looksy over here. Nada. Go down here. Get all my loot. Biotic cultist. Shield battery. Malfunctioning object. Okay. Let us go talk to Father Kyle. Alrighty. Father Kyle.
I am Major Kyle. I know why you've come. We have no quarrel with you. Why can't you just leave us alone?
It's not an option.
You killed two Alliance officers. You had to know how this would end.
They wanted to take me away from here. They wanted me to abandon this place, turn my back on my family. They spoke blasphemy. I did what I could to make their end quick and painless. I had no other choice.
Yes, you did.
It was necessary to protect my children. Only I can keep them safe.
I don't want to kill you, though.
You can still get out of this alive, Major. Surrender and nobody will get hurt.
I respect that you have come under a banner of peace, but I cannot do as you ask. If you take away their father, my children will be helpless.
And you can't help them now.
You ordered your followers to kill those Alliance investigators. You must face the consequences of your actions. Do you really want your children to suffer for your sins too?
No. This was my fault. My children are innocent. Pure. Please. I never meant for this to happen. I'm sorry.
I know this isn't easy.
You're doing the right thing, Major. Your children will be better off for it. Come on.
Wait. If my children see you taking me away, they won't understand. They will attack and you will be forced to kill them all. You have shown me the error of my ways, Commander. Now you must give me time to explain it to them. It is the only way they will understand. Please, give me 1 hour. After that, I will meet the Alliance authorities at the gates of my compound and surrender without violence. I give you my word.
And I believe you.
I'm going to trust you. If you betray that trust, you and all your children will suffer.
I will not betray you, Commander. Thank you for this.
Joker can have the 5th Fleet pick Major Kyle up. I just hope you know what you're doing, Commander.
We should return to the Normandy and notify the Alliance of Kyle's surrender. They'll want to dispatch a ship to take him into custody.
Message coming in. Patching it through.
Admiral Hackett here, Commander. Your helmsman just forwarded your report on Major Kyle. We sent in a team as you instructed. Kyle's followers have disbanded, and the Major surrendered to us without incident. We'll make sure he gets the help he needs. To be honest, Shepard, I thought this thing was going to end in a bloodbath. I don't know how you did it, but you saved a lot of lives. Congratulations.
Thank you. Okay. Well, I actually need to go talk to the rest of the crew real quick. Need to go talk to Garrus and Rex again. I should pick up Liara. I think that's what we're going to go do next. We're going to pick up Liara. Want to start that romance avenue? That wouldn't hurt. Currently, we are about a third of the way through the game, so we're making good progress. We doing good, folks? We doing good?
Commander, good to see you.
Personal questions.
You've been with CSEC a while. Have you seen much action?
Well, not as much as you, but yeah, I've seen some interesting things.
Anything specific?
I'll bet you have. Anything in particular that stands out?
I remember this Solarian geneticist I was sent to investigate. That case was a bit disturbing.
Disturbing?
What happened? Why were you investigating them?
I was tasked with tracking black market trade on the Citadel. Most of it harmless, nothing I needed to pursue. But during the course of my investigation, I noticed an increase in the trade of body parts, organs mostly. We usually get a few of those, but not the numbers I was seeing. We weren't sure if there was a new black market lab or if some freak was harvesting organs from citizens.
That's pretty fucked up. How common is it?
You've seen this before on the Citadel?
Every so often, some lab sells unwanted parts through the black market, but they're not as bad as the Cycles. I remember this one Elcor diplomat we caught in my first year on the job. He was hacking people up and selling their organs, had the station in a bit of a panic. But this case wasn't that clear-cut. Turns out there was more going on than we first realized.
And what did you find?
So how did you figure out what was happening?
First, we got a hold of a sample and ran DNA tests. The weird thing was, the match led us to a Turian who was still alive and was very convinced he'd never lost his liver. After a bit of digging, I discovered this Turian worked briefly for Dr. Salion, the geneticist. So I went to his lab hoping to find evidence of cloned organ development. There was nothing. No Solarian hearts, no Turian livers, not one Krogan testicle.
Krogan testicles?
You're kidding, right? Why would anyone want Krogan testicles?
Some Krogan believe that testicle transplants can increase their virility, counteract the effects of the genophage.
It can't, though.
It doesn't work, but that doesn't stop them from buying. They'll pay up to 10,000 credits each. That's 40,000 for a full set.
I get four balls?
Somebody's making a killing out there.
Yeah. I'm just, like, thinking why they would clone, like, Krogan testicles. Can you imagine the size of those things? Like, the size of those balls? You can literally walk around saying, I got the biggest balls in this joint. I don't know. It was funnier in my head. What about the doctor?
What did you do about the geneticist?
I brought in some of his employees for interrogation, to see if I could get them to talk. While I was interviewing one of them, I came across something suspicious.
Interviewing?
You mean threatened? Was that really necessary?
Maybe, maybe not. Either way, it paid off. One of my detainees started bleeding profusely during the interview. We offered to patch him up, and he got frantic, freaked out. I ordered a full exam to find out what was going on. Our medics found incisions all over his body, some of them fresh.
Ooh.
That was our big break. These people weren't just Dr. Salion's employees. Test tubes. Walking, living test tubes.
That's pretty fucked up.
He was growing parts inside these people?
Exactly. He cloned their organs right inside their own bodies, then he harvested them and sold them off. Most of the victims were poor. He'd pay them each a small percentage of the sales, but only if the organs were good. Sometimes an organ wouldn't grow properly, so he'd just leave it in them.
Wow.
Most of them were a mess, but only on the inside, hidden so nobody could see it.
It's fucked up. Did you get him?
I hope he got what he deserved.
That's the worst part. We never caught him.
And side quest.
Why not? What the hell happened?
He ran, blew his lab, grabbed some of his employees, and headed for the nearest space dock. By the time I found out, his ship was already leaving. He threatened to kill his hostages if we tried to stop him.
That got really quiet right there. And they just let him go to save the hostages.
But you went after him anyway, right?
I ordered Citadel Defense to shoot him down, but CSEC headquarters countermanded my order. They were worried about the hostages, worried about civilian casualties if the ship was destroyed so close to the Citadel.
Understandable.
I told them those hostages were dead anyway. He just used them to make more organs. But they wouldn't listen.
Well, I agree with them. The damage you would have done from blowing up the ship just would have been more damage.
Well, it's not worth the risk. You pursue the vessel and disable it. That's the best choice.
They sent the military after him, but he got away just the same. Yes, they did. I went to Palin and told him what I thought of him and his policies. He said if I didn't like it, I could quit. Well, I almost did. All they had to do was disable that ship, stop him from running. Maybe the hostages die, maybe they don't, but at least we stopped the bastard responsible for it all.
No. Maybe you disable the ship, but you don't try to kill the hostages. They are a priority, sir.
If you don't care about the fate of those hostages, then you're no better than he is.
Exactly.
You're just a terrorist with a badge.
Yeah, maybe you're right. It doesn't make it any easier, but I see your point. Just wish I could have stopped him. That's all.
And Dr. Salion?
Do you have any idea what happened to Dr. Salion?
I sent out feelers from time to time, hoping to find something. I thought I'd found him a while back. He changed ships and changed his name to Dr. Hart, his idea of a joke, I guess. I told the military, but they weren't convinced it was him. I got the transponder frequency for his new ship, but I just can't get anyone to check it out.
Give it to me.
I'll check out the coordinates when I get a chance.
I was hoping you'd say that. But Commander, take me with you when you go. If it's Salion, I want to be there when you find him.
This is the one exception I'm gonna make between the crew choice. So basically I'm taking Rex and Caden with me for the entire game. The one exception I'm making right now is for Garrus' side quest. So I'm probably gonna switch out Caden for that part. But yeah. That should probably do us for that. No more charm. We're close to leveling up Paragon again. I think we're at nearly 40%. Which is not too bad, not too bad at all. I did say I was going to put some points into that. Get Singularity. By the looks of things, it wouldn't actually hurt to get it right now, so I've got more options. Yeah, we don't have anybody else with us. But yeah. So, we're gonna do Garrus' side quest. Rex, what's up, my man?
Shepard?
Personal inquiry.
Why did you become a mercenary?
Lots of reasons.
Yes?
Such as?
Such as, I needed to get out of our system. I needed to eat. I needed to survive.
So why leave?
Why not stay and help your people?
I tried to help. That's why I had to leave.
Really?
What happened?
I was betrayed.
By?
I was head of a small tribe. We were trying to restore order after the war, but the other tribes were against us.
Naturally.
They followed Jared, one of the few warlords who survived the war with the Turians. But he was old, and so were his ideas. He wanted to continue the war. He wanted us to fight. Turians, Salarians, each other. It didn't matter who, as long as we were fighting.
That makes no goddamn sense. Oh, your race is dying? Yeah, sure, let's just help expedite our extinction. And what about you?
What did you want?
I just wanted Jared to shut up. To stop his ranting. I wanted him to stop leading the tribes astray. But he couldn't understand how much things had changed. We didn't have the numbers to go to war. Even if we did, the genophage made sure we couldn't replenish our numbers fast enough. I told them all to forget about war. We needed to focus on breeding, at least for one generation. And for a while, we were getting through. Some of the tribes started coming around.
But Gerard?
I take it the warlord didn't appreciate that.
No, he didn't. He arranged a crush with the tribes. A meeting on neutral ground. He wanted to talk.
I doubt that.
We met at the Hollows, near the graves of our ancestors. The skulls of our dead laid bare to remind us where we come from, and where we all go. It's as sacred as any Krogan place can be. Violence is forbidden.
Well, it would make sense why you went, but why did you go?
It sounds like a trap to me. You must have suspected as much.
I did. But when your father invites you to a crush, well, there are some laws that even we hold sacred.
And he was your dad. Sort of forgot about that detail.
Jared was your father?
He was. Until that day. We talked. But we didn't get anywhere. When it was clear that I wouldn't join him, he gave the signal. His men leapt from the graves of our ancestors like Krogan undead. The few that were loyal to me died quickly. I escaped with my life, but not before I sank my dagger deep into my father's chest.
Petricide.
That is why I left, and that's why I'll never go back.
Your family.
You must have family other than your father. Don't you miss them?
You're trying to make me cry, Shepard.
I'll be a shoulder to cry on.
I've got some unfinished business with my family, but that's all.
Really?
What kind of business?
Before I left, I made an oath to my father's father. I swore to recover my family's battle armor. It was taken from him after the uprising.
The armor?
What's so important about this armor?
It's a relic. Useless, really. But it was worn by 5 generations of my family before the war. It's rightfully mine. Originally, it was taken by the Turian military. We weren't allowed armor or weapons after the war. Now, it's in the hands of Ton Actus, a Turian scum who collects relics from the war. He's made millions selling Krogan artifacts that were stolen from my people.
Yeah, he's a scumbag.
He's got several bases where he stores his goods, all fortified and guarded. I just don't know which base has my family's armor.
We'll find it.
Just tell me where to start looking.
I'll upload the data to your nav system. But Commander, I want to be there when you find him.
Roger, Dodger.
Are your people really dying?
Yeah, okay. So, nothing there. So, we're going to have to postpone Liara until next time. Not terrible, but not preferable either. But yeah, we can finish up these 2 side quests. At the very least, we're gonna do Garrus's side quest. We'll get that out of the way. Okay, so we will go finish up Garrus's side quest and get that out of the way. Galaxy map. Okay, or does that just indicate that we're in orbit around that planet? Ferrous, Pinnacle Station, Asteroid, Lars, Dig Site. Okay, well, we're gonna need to back out. And then go to the journal. Regress, did he let him escape? Kepler Verge. Herschel System, Kepler Verge. Okay. The Herschel System and the Kepler Verge. It's the third time I said that. But that's mostly because I've got a terrible memory. Kepler Verge. Herschel. Beep beep. I'm in my mom's car. We're gonna find the scumbag. Give him a whole bunch of justice to the face. Okay. Third plunge right here. That's the ship. Click on. Check the asteroid field. Yep, there we go. Rocky asteroid. Survey. Okay. What's this right here? Klobaka. Okay. Let's board this ship. So we're gonna bring Garrus and Rex with us. Let's go fuck some things up. Anything here? Nope. That's not a room.
Hostile spotted.
Are they running towards us? There they are. They're like husks. And in fact, they actually almost look like them. Where is Fro? Wait, Singularity. That's Lift. Owie, stop vomiting on me. Dicks. Come on. Lift. Okay, game. That was odd.
Area secured.
If we could not do that again, that'd be awesome. Plasma canister. Thought that was container for a second. I believe green means I'm healing. No, it doesn't. It means I was poisoned. Anything over here? Nope. Okay. Let's go find a scumbag. Good old scumbags. Okay. So he's gonna be in one of these rooms.
Thank you.
Wow.
Thank you for saving that was quick. Those things.
Commander, that's him. That's Dr. Saleon.
What? My name is Hart. Dr. Hart. Please, get me out of here.
You're certain?
Are you sure it's him?
Positive. There's no escape this time, Doctor. I'd harvest your organs first, but we don't have the time.
You're crazy. He's crazy! Please, don't let him do this to me.
Back on, Garrus.
We'll take him in. Drop him off with the military.
But we have him. We can't let him get away. Not again.
Think. Garrus.
If he dies, we'll never know what he's been up to or how he did it. We'll take him in, interrogate him, and he'll serve his time.
Okay. You're right. You're a very lucky Salarian. You owe the commander your life.
Good job, Garrus. Oh,
thank you so very much.
Take cover!
And so he dies anyway. What was the point of that?
I'll tell you.
You can't predict how people will act, Garrus. But you can control how you'll respond. In the end, that's what really matters.
Yeah. I don't think I ever met anyone like you, Commander. Well, I guess we're done here.
Ceylon's medical equipment is stained with the blood of many species. Pale blue, violet, orange, more than a few dark red. But his work has ended here. Time to head back to the Normandy. Okay, everyone. I think that's going to wrap it up for now. Next time, we're going to wrap up Rex's side quest, get his family armor, and complete all of that. Then I think we're going to do Liara. Both in a figurative sense and literally. But yeah, that pretty much wraps it up for now, guys. Thank you guys very much for watching. Be sure to leave a like if you enjoyed the series, so I know to make more videos like it. If you don't, be sure to let me know down below. Leave a dislike. It's always appreciated, especially the feedback. But yeah, that about wraps it up, guys. Thank you guys very much for watching. Once again, I've been SOLIDSNAKEee, and I shall speak to you all next time. Later, guys.